going on? Shalom, everybody. This is your host, Zion Ariala. Welcome to another episode of Thirsty Thursdays. The topic of today, somebody asked me the question, how do you read the Bible? So that's what I'm going to get into today. All right, let's go to the book of Psalms 119 and verse 27. Make me to understand the way of thy precepts. So when we're talking about precepts, we're talking about various different scriptures. All right. So when it says the way of thy precepts, understanding the way of thy precepts means that there are specific ways of how we're supposed to read the Bible. Some people have the wrong way of trying to figure out what the Bible is actually trying to convey. All right, let's go from there. Let's go to Isaiah chapter 28. Isaiah chapter 28 and verse 9. Whom shall he teach knowledge? And whom shall he make to understand doctrine? Everybody has a different doctrine, all right? But there's only one doctrine concerning this Bible. There's only one understanding. It says, them that are weaned from the milk and drawn from the breast, meaning that those that have actually gotten the basics, they've studied to show themselves approved, they're the ones that will begin to really understand what exactly what this Bible is actually telling us. All right, so here's the key. For precept must be upon precept. Precept upon precept. So it reiterates, making sure we understand that you can't just take one scripture and say, okay, well, that's it. John 3:16. You can't do that. You have to make sure that you have another scripture, another verse that gives you the proper understanding. Yes, it solidifies. That's what this is talking about. It says line upon line, line upon line. You can't read one scripture and not contextually read what's above and below it. You have to make sure you know what the book is talking about. Here a little and there a little. So sometimes you may go from one book to another book. You may go from the New Testament to the Old Testament just to make sure that you get a proper understanding. It says, for with stammering lips and another tongue will he speak to this people. Simply saying that no matter what language our people are speaking, he'll make sure that this Bible gets to us so that we can understand what he wants and what he requires of his people. All right, let's go from there. I'm going to give you an example. Genesis chapter 2 and verse 23. It reads, and Adam said, this is now bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. So what is he talking about? All right. Precept. 2 Samuel chapter 19. And let's get verses 11 and 12. And King David sent to Zadok and to Abathar the priest, saying, speak unto the elders of Judah, saying, why are ye the last to bring the king back to his house, seeing the speech of all Israel is come to the king, even to his house? Listen up. Ye are my brethren. Ye are my bones and my flesh. Simply stating what? When Adam was speaking about Eve, saying bone of my bone and flesh of my flesh, he was simply saying she's of my people. She's of my family, of my kind. All right. That's a great example of precept upon precept. So here's another one. Many of you guys have probably actually read this, but you didn't have the proper precept. Therefore, you probably didn't understand what it was talking about. All right. So let's go to the New Testament. St. John chapter 10, and let's read verse 22. And it was at Jerusalem, the feast of dedication, and it was winter. So you say, well, I've read Leviticus 23. I've never seen this feast. What is this talking about? Well, that's because this feast is in the portion of the Bible that's called the Apocrypha. All right, let's go to 1 Maccabees chapter 4. And let's get straight to the point. We'll get verse 59. It says, moreover, Judas and his brethren with the whole congregation of Israel ordained that the days of the dedication of the altar should be kept in their season from year to year by the space of 8 days from the 5 and 20th day of the month Casleu, with mirth and gladness. So this is talking about this particular feast that actually commemorates the victory of Judas and his brethren, the Maccabees. So I like to leave you with one last scripture. So now, last but not least, Acts chapter 17 and verse 11. These were more noble than those in Thessalonica, in that they received the word with all readiness of mind and searched the scriptures daily whether those things were so. Make sure you read the scriptures daily. And with that, I'm going to say shalom.